Hello guys, thanks for joining me today. My name is Busai Obalanleojo and this is Life's Principle. Today, I'll be talking about Nigeria. Majorly, I'll be talking about police brutality. One of the major sectors in the world that needs a thorough recruiting process is the armed force. How do I mean? You pull guns on these people's hand so they can take life anytime. So the recruiting process needs to be thorough. And after that, there should be a checkup, maybe every six months, to know if these people are staying in line, if these people are obeying the rules and regulations, because sometimes these people are drunkards, they are drug addicts that can fire and shoot anybody at any time of the day. That is the truth. Now, some of you are laughing. What is this saying? I bet it with you. It's just a matter of time before they break that your glass house with just one stone. It will only take two policemen to treat you anyhow, irrespective of your power or the money you have. It's not only about the NSAS issue. It's about anyone that has a gun, that has the authority and the backup of the government. To be frank with you, how would SAS go to people's house at 2 a.m. in the morning? Banging the door. People were scared in the neighborhood. Some people already prepared their things and they're ready to drop it. That these are armed robbers. They were banging the door, they broke the glasses, these guys didn't open the door for them. They pointed their gun inside and said they will shoot, but these guys refused to open the door. Even the people in the neighborhood were scared to an extent they started calling the police to come, the popo to come. And now what happens? People were scared in the neighborhood. Imagine if somebody has a bad heart and because of the shouting, the environment in the neighborhood at that particular time, had an heart attack. What would have happened? 2 a.m. SAS disturbing the neighborhood, saying they have a lead on some suspects or the young boys, I don't know, quote unquote. And now, you know, the worst part of this is that these same SAS guys broke into the ceiling, trying entering to this guy's room, and as they were about doing this, these guys opened the door and they ran out. Now the popo, which is the police, came and they discovered that it was SAS. He started questioning them, and why are you here, why are you here, and we have a need. How would SAS go into somebody's house or neighborhood 2 a.m.? When they are not maybe a wanted criminal and you're saying you have a lead, it is wrong. And if the recruiting process or everybody in the armed force of Nigeria needs to be checked, they need to check them. They need to screen them. This is wrong. I was once a victim while traveling at night and this policeman was already drunk and he was asking the driver for money and the driver was not ready to give him the money. He was about cocking his gun and fire. Did ever quickly give him money? When you put a drunkard, how you give a gun to a drunkard? And now some people will say, no, it's the people on the street. It's not the people on the street. Even the ogas at the top, they give these guys, should I say, bill or the amount they need per day. So when you see these guys working and you say you want to call the ogas, they are just laughing because it's even the ogas that gave them the charge. We need to make some amount of money today. This is wrong. So we need to find a solution to it. I bet it with you. If there's no revolution in this country, I'm not sure we are ready for the change. We need revolution.